Welcome back to our fourth maths class. In the previous two classes, we have seen about ratios, six trigonometric ratios, sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, and cot. Now, what their main ratios are, like sine was perpendicular by hypotenuse, cos was base by hypotenuse, tan was perpendicular by base. So that is what you have learned. And then the other three, reciprocal of this thing. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn about standard angles. Now, in trigonometry, there are altogether five standard angles. And these standard angles are 0 degree, then you have 30 degree, then 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. These are called standard angles. Now, when you say standard angles, now all the standard angles have a value. Now, this value is what you have to remember. Now, since you have six ratios and five angles. So 6 into 5 altogether there are 30 values. And all these 30 values is what we have to remember. But then it may become a little difficult to remember all these 30 values. But initially we'll start with writing. Now I'll give you the trick to write this table. How to actually memorize the values. Even if you cannot memorize, in the exam you can create this table, write this table on your answer script. And from this table only you can pick up the values. Because our whole chapter is about writing the values for this standard angle. Again, I am repeating, there are five standard angles. They are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Now, what these standard values are? Now, maybe in today's video, I am going to make it very short. I will discuss only about this table only. And then maybe tomorrow, tomorrow's video again. Tomorrow, even though you don't have math, I will be putting up one more video tomorrow. So that by tomorrow, when the next video is coming for your exercises, you should be all ready with the values of this standard angle. Yes, try to make the table. Whatever table I am making here, you will also try to make the table. If you can memorize, it's very good. All 30 values. But as such, now at this moment, it may not be possible. So rather than memorizing, now learn how to make this table. Now let me tell you what I mean by this 30 values. And see, the standard angles are 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90. Now, let me write down the value now, sine. Sine 0 degree is 0, so sine 0 value is 0. Similarly, sine 30 value is half, sine 45 value is 1 by root 2, sine 60 value is root 3 by 2, and your 90 value is 1. So, sine 90 value is 1. So, now that means if somebody asks you, what is sine 60? So, immediately you should know, okay, sine 60 is root 3 by 2. What is sine 45? 1 by root 2. Sine 90, 1. Sine 0, 0. Sine 30, half. This is what should be there in your mind. Now, similarly, cos. Now, I'll write for all six. That is why I said 30. So one value, one trigonometric ratio, five values. So, six are there. 6 into 5, 30 values. Similarly, cos. Cos 0 is 1. Then, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Cos 60 is half. And cos 90 is 0. Then, tan. Tan 0 is 0, tan 30 is 1 by root 3, tan 45 is 1, tan 60 is root 3 and tan 90 is undefined. Now what is the meaning of undefined? Let me tell you. When any number, when you are dividing by 0, doesn't matter 1, 2, 3, 4, any number. Whenever the denominator is 0, you know, we don't have the answer to this. So we call this as undefined. A slipping 8, 8 is slipping. Whereas when 0 is divided by any number here, 1, 2, 3, 4, the answer is 0. So, there is a difference between dividing by 0 and 0 being divided. If 0 is being divided by any number, then it is 0. But when 0 is dividing any number, then it is undefined. So, this is what is undefined. And yes, you should know that 0 is the reciprocal. Reciprocal of undefined and undefined is the reciprocal of 0. So, they are reciprocal to each other. So, yes, you have sine, cos and tan. And similarly, cosec. Now, if you know sine value, you know cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So, whatever values you have written here, I have to reciprocal it. So, cosec value, 0 reciprocal is undefined, just now I discussed. 1 by 2 becomes 2, 2 by 1, 2 by 1 is 2. 1 by root 2 becomes root 2. Root 3 by 2 becomes 2 by root 3. So, then 2 has gone up, root 3 has come down and the reciprocal of 1 is 1. This is what is the value of cosec. Similarly, sec is the reciprocal of cos. So, cos value here, so 1 reciprocal is 1. Root 3 by 2 reciprocal is 2 by root 3. And 1 by root 2 reciprocal is root 2. And you have 1 by 2 as 2 and reciprocal 0. Then we discuss 0 reciprocal undefined. So, sec. And finally, cot. Cot is the reciprocal of tan. If tan 0 is 0, reciprocal of 0, reciprocal of 0 is undefined. So if this is 0, so this becomes undefined. So 1 by root 3 becomes root 3, reciprocal, root 3 is going up. 1 reciprocal is 1, whereas root 3 reciprocal is 1 by root 3, and reciprocal of undefined is 0. Yeah, 30 values are there. So if you see, all the 30 values will be there in your head. If you can memorize, it's very good. But in case if you cannot memorize, I'll give you the trick to remember this table. How you are going to remember this table. Now, how you can create this table? So you can write this table like in the exam, you can create this table in your answer script and pick the values. Yeah, I said in the beginning that this chapter is very easy. It's easy only if you know the table, because all questions are based on the table. Okay, now then see, how to create the table? You don't need to memorize it, follow this technique, follow this step, easily you will be able to make the table. Alright, there you go. Starting with 0, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees. So write down numbers like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the first step is write from 0 to 4. Not from 1 to 5. Don't write 1, 2. You have to write whole number, not natural number, whole number. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So write this serial numbers from 0 to 4. First step. Immediately follow this first step by dividing all this number by 4. So divide all these numbers by 4 and then write down what is the value. 0 by 4 is 0. 1 by 4 is, it is 1 by 4. 2 by 4 means 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are. So it is 1 by 2. This is 3 by 4 and 4 and 4 cancellation will give you 1. Okay, second step. First step, write from 0 to 4. Second step, divide all the numbers by 4 and write the simplified form here. Second step. Third and the last step is, for this number, find out the square root. What is the square root of this number? Okay, now when you find the square root for numerator and denominator, separately find the square root. Square root of 0 is 0. 1 square root is 1. Upper side. Square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 1 is 1. Square root of 2 is not there, so we'll write it as root 2 only. Same way, 3. We'll write root 3 because 3 doesn't have a square root. 4 square root is 2. 1 square root is 1. Yeah, three steps. First step, 0 to 4, divided by 4, second step. Then third step, find the square root and write down the value. Whatever value that you got here just now is the value of sine. Now here, sine 0 degrees 0, sine 30 degrees half, sine 45 degrees 1 by root 2, sine 60 degrees root 3 by 2, sine 90 1. So this is exactly the same value that I wrote a little while ago. This value, see how easily you can create this sine. So only creating sine is a problem. Now once you have created sine, now see how easily others will come out. Now, when you are finding the value of cos, what is the value of sine? The cos value write in reverse order, reverse. There you see 1. So, here first number will be 1. Now, after 1, when you come back, next one will be root 3 by 2. So, this is root 3 by 2. Then after this, next is 1 by root 2. So, both values are same. As you can see, 45, sine 45 and cos 45 values are same, 1 by root 2. Then after this, you have to go there, half. And after that, 0. So, that means, as you can see, cos value is the reverse of sine. So there is 0, there is x. Half, next. 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2, 1. So cross, criss-cross you can call it as. So once you know sine, cos also is very easy. Okay, now before I tell you what is tan, you should know that tan is sine by cos. If you are dividing sine by cos, it comes tan. Now I'll tell you why. Sine is perpendicular by hypotenuse and cos is base by hypotenuse. You have learned this already in the previous chapter. Now if I cancel this hypotenuse, it becomes P by B. And you know that perpendicular base is tan. Perpendicular base is tan. That is why if you want to find tan, you can divide sine by cos. Okay, why am I telling you that? Because to find the value of tan, I have to divide this sine value by cos value. Let's divide sine by cos. Okay, again I should tell you that whenever 0 is divided by any number, the answer is 0. But when 0 is divided by another number, any number, then it is undefined and they are reciprocal to each other. Okay, tan. Now think that I am dividing the upper line by the lower line. Think, just imagine that, okay, there is a line and 0 is divided by 1. And when 0 is divided by 1 or when 0 is divided by any number, the answer is 0. Okay, so since you are imagining only. Okay, yes, again, let's divide this number by this. Okay, 2 and 2, think that you have, they are cancelled, so you have 1 by root 3. So the value is 1 by root 3. Okay, again, don't forget that. We are only imagining and cancelling in our mind only. Then here, divide this by this. So root 2 and root 2 is cancelled, 1 by 1. 1 by 1 is 1. Then again, as you are dividing this denominator 2 and 2 is cancelled, it's root 3 by 1. Root 3 by 1 means denominator 1 has no significance. I am writing only root 3. and here 1 is divided by 0. Whenever 1 is divided by 0, so tan 30 is undefined. Now I got the value of tan. So if you have sine, cos and tan, then you know the other three exactly the same way I am going to write now. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine. Sec is the reciprocal of cos. Tan is the reciprocal of, cot is the reciprocal of tan. So here it is, sine and cosec, they are reciprocal to each other. So 0 reciprocal is undefined. 1 by 2 becomes 2. 1 by root 2 becomes root 2 by 1 or root 2. This becomes 2 by root 3 and 1 reciprocal is 1. This is what is cosec value. Then sec. Sec is the reciprocal of cos. Okay, here it is. Cos and sec, they are reciprocal to each other. So 1 reciprocal is 1. Root 3 by 2 becomes 2 by root 3. 1 by root 2 becomes root 2. 1 by 2 becomes 2. 0 reciprocal is undefined. Okay, this is what is sec reciprocal of cos. If you want, by the way, how you took cos from sine? Reverse of sine. What was the sine value? Cos, you wrote reverse. Same thing you can do with here with cosec and sec also. Sec is the reverse of cosec. Now sec 1, this 1, then 2 by root 3, root 2, 2 undefined. So this is the reverse of this. Or you can do it also from reciprocal. Now finally tan. Tan reciprocal is cot. Okay, so whatever is the value of tan. Or if you want, you can divide this by this also. You can also do that, but it will be easier if you do the reciprocal of this. Reciprocal of 0, undefined. 1 by root 3 becomes root 3. 1 reciprocal is 1. Root 3 reciprocal is 1 by root 3. Undefined 0. So there you are. Very, very easily you can create the table. So again, I will tell you what I have done. Just a revision. First thing, you have to remember, by the way, other things you can create, but you have to remember the standard angles. Remember, there are 5 of them. 0, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. So write on the top. Then write whole number from 0 to 4, whole number, okay, starting with 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. First step. Second step, all these numbers divide by 4. All these numbers, if you divide by 4, then simplified form will come like this. Then this simplified form, find the square root. And when you are finding the square root, numerator and denominator separately write. Square root of 0 is 0, 1 square root is 1, 4 square root is 2, 1 square root is 1. 2 doesn't have a square root, so it will be root 2. Same, 3 doesn't have a square root, root 3. Square root of 4 is 2. 1 square root is 1. That will give you the value of sine. And cos, write reverse of sine. What you wrote for sine, reverse. Tan, how we found tan? Tan is this divided by this. Because sine by cos, there, sine by cos is tan. So divide sine value by cos value. 0 by 1, 0. 1 by 2, divide by root 3 by 2. 2 to cancel, 1 by root 3. Divide this by this, 1. This by this, divide, you'll get tan. Then cosec, sec and cos, they are the reciprocal of each other. Now, let us see, how do we solve question? And by the way, you cannot do a single question if you do not know this value. If you know this value, all questions become very, very easy. That's why in the beginning only I said, in the previous class also I said that our next chapter is going to be very interesting and easy. Easy, if you can. I hope you can. Even if you cannot memorize it now, at least you can create this table somewhere and from there you can pick up the value. So now you start practicing. So just now, pause the video and start practicing this, what I told you. So do it 2-3 times till you are perfect in creating the table. I'm only talking about creating the table now. Yes, those of you who can memorize it. Okay, but then that is not necessary, because the more question you practice from this exercise, I think automatically most of the values will stay in your mind. So if it is there in the mind, like how I wrote all values automatically, you know, you should also be able to get the values, know the values. And yes, all together there are 30 values. But I would say 30 values, but then main is this one, up to 10. So if you know this, the rest of them, that is 15 values only you have to remember, the other 15 are reciprocal only. So for example, if cosec is there, then remember sine. Okay, reciprocally. So if you know what is sine, 30 degrees. So you know it is 1 by 2. But if somebody asks you what is cosec 30, and you know cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So okay, remember then sine, okay, sine 30 is 1 by 2, okay, cosec will become, 1 by 2 becomes 2 by 1, 2 by 1 is 2. So that is how you have to remember the remaining three. Okay, I am now doing some questions from your textbook. So this is exercise 20. Our previous exercise was 19. This is exercise 20. Yeah, even though I'll be uploading the questions and the answer of the whole exercise, but as I said, maybe by one more video I'm going to upload it, giving you the second part. If possible, I'll do it maybe today or maybe by tomorrow or maybe at the most by Sunday, you'll see one more video. So that's why, in case if you are not able to solve other questions, I think by showing you one, two questions, I think you people can solve other questions also. But then, in case if you cannot, one more video I am going to make to complete all different types of questions here. Okay, I am starting then with question number one. It says, tan square 60 over cos square 45 into cos square 90 over sin square 30. Into tan 30 degree. So you can see all angles that you see here, they are all standard angles, standard, those out of those 5 ones. Now, without knowing the value, you cannot solve this question. You should know the value, then only you can solve. See, tan 60. Now, see the table which you have created. Now, you have practiced just now. So, see in that table, what is sin your tan 60? So, I know the value, so that's why I am writing it. So, tan 60 is root 3. But since there is a square, there it is. I am squaring it. Similarly, cos 45, again see cos under 45, see how to see cos, see, and then there is 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90. So cos 45 means cos, you go in this line and come down from 45, so that value. So cos 45 value, you see, it is 1 by root 2 square, because square is there, into cos 90 value, you see, it is 0, it is 0 square, sin 30 value is half, half square, and tan 30 value is 1 by root 3. Now I know automatically that the answer will come 0 because one of the value is 0 and we are multiplying all of this. And when 0 is multiplied with any number, no matter how big or small they are, you know your answer is 0. But since here we are practicing only, so let's solve the whole thing. Root 3 into root 3. Root 3 square is 3. This is 1 by 2 because 1 square is 1. Root 2 into root 2 is 2. Into this is 0. This is 1 by 4. 1 square and 2 square into 1 by root 3. Okay, I am taking this 1 by 2 up. It will be 3 into 1 by 2 becomes 2 by 1 into 0 into 1 by 4 becomes 4 by 1 into 1 by root 3. So now I will not multiply because one of the number is 0. So that's why your final answer is what will be 0. Now, okay, you may also face a small problem with question number 2. There are 3 questions in question number 2. So let me do that 2, 3. It is 4 sine to the power 4. 30 plus cos to the power 4, 30 minus 3 sin square 45 minus sin square 90. Okay, so you have to find the value. So maybe I am taking this question because power of 4, what is to be done, you may have a problem. Okay, 4. Sin 30 value is half. Now check the table. Sin 30 value is half. To the power 4, so I have to power it 4 times, multiply 4 times. Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2, that also I will power it 4, minus this is 3. Sin 45 value is 1 by root 2, this I will square it, and sin 90 value is 1, this also I am squaring it. Okay, now we need to solve 4. 1 into 1 into 1, 1 4 times, so when you are powering it will become 1, 2 to the power 4, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 is what is 16, plus root 3 into root 3, okay, yes, let's see, root 3 into root 3 into root 3 into root 3, since you know root 3 into root 3 is 3, and again another root 3 into root 3 is 3, so 3 into 3 is 9, so this becomes 9 over again 2 to the power 4 is 16, like this, minus 3. 1 square is 1, root 2 into root 2 is 2, minus this is 1, 1 square is 1, this is 4, okay, taking 16 as an LCM, so this will be 1 plus 9 minus 3, again taking 2 as an LCM, will be 1 minus 2, so this is 4 into, okay, 1 plus 9 is 10 by 16, minus 3 into, 1 minus 2 is minus 1 by 2, so 4 will cancel here 4 times. So 2 will cancel 2 and 5 times. Now there are no cancellations. So this is 5 by 2 minus into minus is plus and 3 into 1 is 3 by 2. So it is 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2. Taking 2 as an LCM. So if you add 5 plus 3, so So that is giving you 8 by 2, and that 8 by 2 is 44. So this is how you solve. Okay, let me also show you a question with you are asked to let's see now in question number 4 they are saying if A is equal to 30, now you are not given standard angle but rather you are given A or B or C, but A value is given as 30, which is standard. So now in 4 also two questions are there. Let me do the second one. In the second one it says so that cos 2A, so that means you have to prove left hand side is and right hand side they are same, 1 minus tan square A over 1 plus tan square A. So prove that what you see there on the left hand side is same, but don't forget A is, you have to put the standard angle, this 30 value you have to put there, and so that left hand side and right hand side they are coming the same. Okay, then here you go, cos 2 into 2A is 2 into A is 30, 1 minus again tan square 30, 1 plus tan square 30, then this is cos 60 degrees is equal to 1 minus tan 30, tan 30 if you look at the value, tan 30 value is 1 by root 3, and since there is a square, so here it is, I am squaring it. Same way on the lower side also it is 1 plus tan 30, again tan 30 is 1 by root 3, this also I will square it. So tan cos 60 by the cos 60 value is half. So left hand side I already have the value half, so right hand side also somehow I have to get half. So this is 1 minus 1 square is 1, root 3 into root 3 is 3. Same way 1 plus this also is 1 by 3, still left hand side is half, right hand side taking the LCM on the upper side as 3, so this is 1 over 3, 3 into 1 is 3 minus 1, similarly lower side 3, so this is what is 3 plus 1, cancelling this 3 and 3, so you have half equal to this 3 minus 1 is 2 and 3 plus 1 is 4, if you cancel it, so there you are, half equal to half, so now you can say left hand side equal to right hand side. So this is how you solve question where you have to show or when angles are given in this form. Okay, now let us see question number 6. Here you have only one angle as A equal to 30. Now here in question number 6 you are given two angles, one is 30, they are saying A is 30 and B is 60. If A is 30 and B is 60, then the question is telling you so that or prove that or verify that sine A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Yeah, this is one trigonometric formula which you will learn in class 11, but now here we only have to verify, you only have to prove left hand side equals right hand side. Okay, let's put the values of A and B. A and B values are given. Sine A is 30, B is 60. Then this is sine 30 cos 60. Plus cos 30 sine 60. Now I only need to put the values and solve. Okay, but before that, yes, don't put sine 30 and sine 60. You have to add it and write sine 90 equal to. Now I'm going to put the value. Sine 30 value is half, and cos 60 value is also half. Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2 into sine 60 value is also root 3 by 2. So now sine 90 from the table, if you see, sine 90 value is what? And this is 1 by 4 plus root 3 into root 3 is 3, 2 into 2 is 4. Okay, 1, right side LCM is 4, 1 plus 3. So 1 equal to 4 by 4 when you cancel. So you are getting 1 is equal to 1. Okay, so you can try questions. Okay, 7, 8, 9. Till 9 you can try. Till next video is coming, maybe from question.